This is some significant news out of the state of Georgia. First of all, Georgia, as a lot of you know, is one of the states that will determine who becomes the next U.S. president. And it is a swing state. Now, last month, the state election board, which recently has changed so that it is controlled not just by Republicans, but more conservative, Trump-friendly Republicans, that state election board last month passed a new rule requiring that workers, after the polls closed, three poll workers would have to count each paper ballot in Georgia. Fulton County, which is generally a Democratic-leaning county, objected to this, went to court over it. They said that was unreasonable and that the election board was beyond its authority in passing that rule. One concern for people was that if Trump was going to lose Georgia, if Trump lost Georgia, that he would use this rule as sort of an excuse and push so that those who back him would not certify any win by Harris. Well, a Fulton County judge has ruled that, that requirement cannot take place. He said it was too late and it was too much. And so now that hand counting requirement will not be in place for this election. And we also know something else out of Georgia. The state, just in the very first day of its early voting, set an all-time record. More than 250,000 early votes in Georgia. That's incredible. They still have two more weeks of early voting to go, and the Secretary of State of Georgia says they do expect to set a record.